And I'm so excited to see what the hell you do to this pussy, mouth, butthole, hand, whatever it is. I'm so excited. Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Go Tom!
I'm gonna let you do your thing. I'm gonna set you up real nice though, okay? Because these people are gonna pop so big when I say your name, then your song will play, and then we're gonna watch you fuck something that we cannot see. That's what we're doing with our lives on a Saturday night here in Louisiana, and I'm so excited. It's not working right now. You will figure it out. It's coming! Energy restored!
Can you make your stay more magical?
Charles the cunt fucker, the stool destroyer, the limp dick defeater, most importantly, the cunt fucker. How do you feel right now?
Well, I feel like a little bit sexy. I'm trying to feel sexy right now. That's what I'm trying. That's what I'm going for is sexy.
You fucking own it, man. You just did one of the weirdest, most sexy things I've ever seen in my whole life.
No, that's what I meant. Is that I am sexy. That's what I am. That's what I meant to say. So I'm very sexy. I'm just like.
Dude, you're fucking sexy. You're fucking sexy. Let's talk to our judging panel. You hang out with me. I'm gonna hold on to you so you don't run away. All right, Brock LeBoer, give me some thoughts right now on Charles the cunt fucker.
Charles. I
I'm so sorry about the technical mishaps up here. I hope that didn't throw you off too much. Is that why you fucked like that? Because of what I did? Or were you...
Yeah, that's like my regular life. That's what I tried for.
Okay, good. Because I was feeling guilty the whole time. But honestly, that was cool as fuck what you did when you rolled off the stage like that and you knocked a stool over and you reversed it back
up. Like, you can't pay attention to shit that's in your way. You just gotta fuck. Right?
Oh my god. True words have never been spoken in the history of the Air Sex Championships. Put it on a t-shirt. I love it.
Thank you, Charles. Very much. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Brock LeBourne. Jason Leonard.
Yeah. I now know what you get if you reach level 42 in Dungeons & Dragons. Also, I feel bad for all those times in elementary school I made fun of special needs kids. So, but Charles, you fucked it. I like it.
Thank you, Jason. Lacey!
I don't know! like, how do you keep going so long with it so limp?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, he had a limp dick for a long time, and he changed that limp dick. That pussy, how wet does a pussy have to be for a limp dick to slide on in? Okay, thank you. What?
Puss in rope?
Pushing, is that what it's called? Wait, are you serious? Wait, hold on. I gotta learn something now. Time out in the show. Pushing rope is putting a limp penis inside of a wet cloth. How many people knew this already? Y'all decided to make me look like a fool up here and come up with a new phrase. But guess what? I'm gonna take that phrase all over the country now. Pushing rope is putting your flaccid ding dong inside that wet fall fall. Credit Lafayette.
John. I noticed he was like throwing his partner around a lot. With superhuman ease. And I feel like either he has superhuman strength, it was a midget, or an anorexic model.
Well, the most politically correct way to say that is he's really strong.
I'm gonna say, yeah. He's right.
Why are you flipping people off? You just had sex. Is this how you act when you have sex in real life? You just walk around flipping people off? Don't do that to yourself, Charles the Pink Fucker.
Either way, it was impressive, is all I'm saying.
Super impressive. Thank you, John. Y'all gotta make some noise for